Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to make this Russian constructivist poster, which I based on this poster by Alexander Rodchenko, one of the founders of constructivism. I provided a Photoshop template for you to download so you can follow along. Its link is located in the video description or project files. I also provided links to the fonts we'll be using. If you're not sure how to install fonts, watch my tutorial on how to do this. I provided that link as well. The template includes some basic elements of the design. Click off the eyeball of the circle to temporarily hide it, and click on the thumbnail of layer 2 to make it active. Click on the new layer icon to make a new layer above it. We'll fill it with white. To do this, press Shift plus the F5 key on your keyboard. Choose white, then click OK. Go to Filter and Filter Gallery. Open the Sketch folder and choose Halftone Pattern. The pattern type is line, the contrast is 50, and the size is 8. Then click OK. Go to Select and Color Range. Choose Shadows. The fuzziness and range are 0. And tick Selection. Then click OK. We can trash the pattern since we have its selection. Go to a red area and press the letter I to open the eyedropper tool. Left click to pick up its color and press Alt or Option plus Delete to fill the selection with the foreground color, which is red. Delete the selection by pressing Ctrl or Command D. Hide the bottom three layers. Open your Paint Bucket tool and make sure Contiguous is checked. Click between the red stripes to fill that area in and click on the next empty area. Skip the next empty area and click on the following two. Continue to fill in two and skip one. Click on the foreground color and type in 253073 and click OK or press Enter or Return. Click on the fourth stripe to fill it with a dark blue color. Click on the empty area below it to fill that in as well. Continue until the fourth stripe from the bottom is also filled with blue. Go to View and make sure Rulers and Snap are checked. If they aren't, just click on them. Press D on your keyboard to make the foreground and background colors black and white respectively. Open the Rectangular Marquee tool, go to the upper left corner, and drag out a selection to the bottom and 9 inches across. Press Alt or Option plus Delete to fill it with black and then delete the selection. Make all the layers visible and go to Edit, Transform and Perspective. Go to the top left corner and drag straight down to 4.5 inches. Make sure the vertical edge of the black triangle doesn't overlap the light colored stripes. Then press Enter or Return. Hide the circle layer. Go to the top left corner and drag out a rectangle to the bottom of the document and the edge of the crisscross. Press Delete on your keyboard to delete the black area to the left of the crisscross. Then delete the selection. Make the circle layer visible again and double-click on the thumbnail of layer 3 to open its layer style window. Click Stroke and the color box. Click on the light color and click OK. Make the size 10 pixels and the position is outside. Then click OK or press Enter or Return. We need to hide the top and bottom lines in the red area. To do this, make a new layer and press Z to open your zoom tool. Drag a rectangle over the top corner. To see more to the right of your image, press and hold the space bar as you drag your image. Open your Rectangular Marquee tool and drag a rectangle to the top edge of the light color. Press and hold Shift as you continue to add rectangular selections over the top light colored stripe. Press I to open your eyedropper tool and click on the red color. Press Alt or Option plus Delete to fill the selection with red. Then delete the selection. Go to the bottom of your document, open your rectangular marquee tool again, and repeat the same steps to cover the light colored stripe. To see your image at 100%, press Ctrl or Command 1. Make the circle layer active and double-click it to open its layer style window. Click Stroke and the color box. Click on the light color and click OK. Make the size 10 pixels. Click Inner Glow and the color box. Click on the black area and click OK. Make the blend mode Dissolve and the opacity 80%. Make the size 70 pixels and click OK. Next, we'll place an image into the blue circle. Open an image you'd like to use. It can be anything relevant to your poster. We need to make a selection around it in order to cut it out from its background. For this example, I'll use the Quick Selection tool and use a relatively small size. I'll drag the tool over the image until I've made a selection of it all. To see the selection, I'll press the letter Q to make it into a quick mask. If you need to retouch your quick mask, you can use your brush tool. I'll press Q again to revert it back into a selection. To cut your image out from its background, press Ctrl or Command J. Press V to open your Move tool and drag it up onto the tab of your poster. Without releasing your mouse or pen, drag it down onto the poster and release. Ctrl click or Command click on the thumbnail of the circle to make a selection of its shape. Click on the layer mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection. Click off the chain link, which unlinks the image and the layer mask. This allows us to move either one independently of the other. Make the image active and drag it to a position you like. If you want to resize or rotate it, press Ctrl or Command T to open your transform tool. Go to a corner, and when you see a diagonal double arrow, press and hold Shift and Alt on Windows or Shift and Option on a Mac as you drag it in or out. Click inside to reposition it. To angle it, go to a corner, and when you see a curved double arrow, rotate it. Continue to adjust it until you're happy with its size, position, and angle. Then press Enter or Return. If you have color fringe surrounding it, go to Layer, Matting, and Defringe. I'll defringe it by 2 pixels. Next, we'll convert the image into a black and white halftone. Go to Filter and Filter Gallery. The halftone pattern filter should still be open from the last time. Change the pattern type to Dot. Adjust the size and the contrast to your liking. I'll make the contrast 3 and the size 1. Next, we'll give it an aged sepia color. Click on the adjustment layer icon and choose Color Lookup. If you have version CS5 or earlier, click Photo Filter and choose the sepia option. Click the Clip to Layer icon, which restricts the adjustment layer to affect just the one layer beneath it. If you don't clip it, the adjustment layer will affect all the layers beneath it in the Layers panel. Another way to clip it is to press Ctrl-Alt-G on Windows or Command-Option-G on a Mac. Click Load 3D LUT and choose Candlelight Cube. We're ready to add text. Open your Horizontal Type tool and click on your document. I'm using Kremlin Minister Black. If you'd like to use it or a similar font called Kremlin, I provided their links. I'll make the size approximately 30 points, sharp, and left alignment. Click the color box, click the light color, and click OK. Type out your text. Click on your Move tool and open your Transform tool. Drag it to the left and enlarge it until it fits comfortably in the top red area. Then press Enter or Return. Make a copy of your text by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Press and hold Shift as you drag it straight down until it fits comfortably on the bottom red shape. Press T to open back up your Type tool and highlight your first word. Click on the color box and pick black. Then click OK. Make your other text layer active and highlight the second word at the top. Click on the color box and again pick black. Open your Move tool and click on the top layer. Open your Type tool and click on the black area. For the next font, I'm using LVDC Common 2, which I also provided its link to. Click on the color box and click on the red to pick up its color. Type out your text. Click on your Move tool and open your Transform tool. Resize and position it relative to the text to its right. Then press Enter or Return. You can still move it if you'd like. Make a copy of it and press and hold Shift as you drag it down. Repeat these steps to create text on the blue shape. Open your Type tool and left-click on the black shape. Click on the color box and click on the red to pick up its color. Click OK and type out your text. Open your Move tool, drag your text to the left, and open your Transform tool. Resize and position it. Make a copy of it and drag the copy just below the text above it. Open your Type tool, highlight the text, and type in another word. Open your Move tool and your Transform tool. Resize and position it so it's aligned with the length of the other text. We'll merge these text layers by shift-clicking on the large T of the lower layer and pressing Ctrl or Command E. Next, we need to find the horizontal center of the triangular shape. To do this, scroll down and make its layer active. Open your Transform tool, click on the top ruler, and drag down a guideline to the center until it snaps in place. Then press Enter or Return. If you don't see it, press Ctrl or Command H. Scroll back up and make the top layer active. Open your Transform tool and drag it to the middle until it snaps in place. Center it on the black shape and go to Edit, Transform, and Perspective. Go to the top right corner of the Transform and drag it up. If you want, you can go to the top left corner and drag it down a little. Drag it to the left or right to center it. Then press Enter or Return. Hide the guideline by pressing Ctrl or Command H. The edge of the text has gotten a bit soft after we distorted it with the Transform tool, so let's clean it up. Open your Rectangular Marquee tool and drag a selection a bit over the edge of your text. Press the Delete key to delete the area of the text inside the selection. Then delete the selection. Repeat the steps for the other areas that appear too soft. Next, we'll add a border that surrounds the entire poster. Make a new layer and fill it with any color. I'll fill it with white. Reduce the fill to 0. Double-click on the thumbnail to open its layer style window. Click Stroke and the color box. Click the light color and click OK. Make the position inside and the size 10 pixels, then click OK. Next, we'll add texture to the olive green shapes. First, we'll make a composite snapshot of our image. To do this, press Ctrl-Shift-Alt-E on Windows or Command-Shift-Option-E on a Mac. Open your Magic Wand tool. Make the tolerance anywhere between 0 and 50, and make sure Contiguous is checked. Click on the top green shape to make a selection of it. Then, press and hold Shift as you click on the lower green shape to add that selection. Press Ctrl or Command J to cut and copy the shapes to their own layer. Double-click on the thumbnail to open its layer style window. Click Inner Glow and the color box. Type in 696322, then click OK. Make the blend mode dissolve and the opacity 60%. Make the size 30 pixels and click OK. Next, we'll add some texture to the poster. First, make another composite snapshot and go to Filter and Filter Gallery. Open the texture folder and click Texturizer. Make the texture sandstone, the scaling is 100%, the relief is 4, and the light is from the top. Then click OK. If you'd like to give it stains and scratches, open your brush tool and click on the gear icon. I provided the link to this great brush set of stains and scratches created by Doghouse Design Studio. If you're not sure how to install brushes, watch my tutorial on how to do this. I provided that link as well. When you see this window, click OK to see just this brush set in the thumbnail window. I'll click the last brush for this example. Notice the size is quite large at 2500 pixels. I'll reduce it to 1800 pixels and reduce the opacity to 25%. Go to the center of the image and left click. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.